This video is going to be about why I'm glad I was ashamed and embarrassed growing up as a kid. As I've mentioned in previous videos, I was raised in the Seventh-day Adventist denomination, and in addition to attending the church, my mother would enroll me in the Seventh-day Adventist school if the particular church we were attending had a school. Just like most of the other denominations, especially in the South, the churches are voluntarily segregated by race. We didn't always go to the white church, but we did during some of my most impressionable years, round about ages 8 through 12. Now, before you start thinking you know where this story is going, I want to say this. I never experienced any racism from the children whatsoever, not even once. They treated me like I was one of them. That said, here's where I was different from them, and this is what I was embarrassed about. There was about 35 to 40 kids in that school, including me, and I don't think there was ever more than 4 black kids or so at one time in the school. Every single other child at that school came from a 2-parent home. But for me, it was just me and my mom. Also, my mom was a student at the time, and she had a work-study job instead of, I guess, a quote-unquote real job, so there wasn't much money. She kept the basics paid for, kept me fed pretty well, but every now and again the lights would go out, and sometimes the church members would bring us food, or sometimes the car would break down and she wouldn't be able to get it fixed for several weeks or maybe like a month or two. I wouldn't say we were poor because, again, we did stay afloat, but compared to the other kids at the school, I was pretty close to being classified as poor. And just to remind you, this was a private school where, of course, you had to pay tuition. And I'm not saying none of the other parents had to use payment plans or cut back in other areas to be able to afford the tuition, but still they all at least appeared to be living a middle-class lifestyle, which afforded them the opportunity to take vacations in the summertime and afford things that my mother couldn't get for me. So I would come back to school after the summer and hear how they went water rafting in Grand Rapids or something, or how they went to Disneyland or backpacking in Europe. And the best story I would have is the good time I had with my cousins and my grandparents back in Memphis, Tennessee, which is not too shabby, but still, you know, when you're hearing about Disneyland and all that stuff, it kind of pales in comparison. And also, one thing I forgot to mention as far as the not having the father situation, it's hard for me to describe now the feeling I felt when my friends would talk about, oh, my dad did this and my dad that, but I just remember feeling really bad about it. One thing I really hated about not having a dad, and this is just one thing and it may sound silly, but I always wanted to be picked up. If you just have your mom, once you get about 4 or 5, you're done being picked up for the rest of your life. But if you have a dad, you can get picked up for a little bit longer. And, you know, he can pick you up and throw you and roll you across the floor, stuff like that. And I know some people are going to come back and say, well, I didn't have my dad and we didn't have a lot of money, but I held my head high, ain't nothing to be ashamed of. Well, to those of you who say that, let me ask you this. Was everybody else who was around you when you were growing up, were they in the same position? Was everybody else fatherless and broke? Because if that's the case, then that's the difference. If where you live, everybody's doing the same thing and they're in the same condition or predicament, whatever you want to say, then whatever everybody's doing is going to be considered quote-unquote normal. So if I'm on welfare and you're on welfare and she's on welfare and they're on welfare and we all live in the same place, then there's no shame to being on welfare because everybody's on welfare. But if you're in an environment where everybody else has a daddy and you don't, and when everyone else is talking about their daddies or giving a daddy story and you don't have one, that sucks. And it's embarrassing, as it should be. And I'm glad that since I didn't have my dad in my life, at least not full time, I was still able to get the idea in my head that a family should have a mother and a father by being around kids who had a mother and a father and being embarrassed because my family was broken. But it didn't just stop there. Since sometimes our lights would go out, it didn't happen often, but it was every now and again. And like I said before, sometimes the church members would have to bring us food, or sometimes we'd have to go for a while without getting the car fixed when it broke down. And also because my friends were getting things from their parents that my mother was not able to provide for me, I got this mindset that when I grow up, if there's something I want to do and I'm not able to do it, I don't want the reason that I can't do it to be because I can't afford it. Now, of course, there's always going to be things I can't afford. Even Oprah has limits. But I mean stuff as far as going on vacation. If I can't go on vacation, it'll be because I broke my leg or because I'm running a business and I can't get away. But it's not going to be because I can't afford it. And if I decide to have kids, I'm going to want to have to stay home with them. But if I can't stay home with my kids, it's going to be because I don't have any kids and not because I can't afford to. And also, those two things, not having a dad and not having as much money and privilege as everybody else around me, that also affected the men I would date or consider for marriage. Once I got out of school, I would only accept advances from men of a certain level, and if they weren't on that level, I wouldn't entertain them at all. Sorry, it was nothing personal, but I was trying to go up, not down, because I'd already been down and I didn't like it, and I don't want to go back. So anyway, that's why I'm glad I was embarrassed about my situation when I was growing up. It challenged me to do better and not make the mistakes my mom made. And when I think about what inspired me to do better, it makes me kind of pessimistic about kids in the inner city. Because like I said, if you live in a place and everybody's doing the same thing, then that thing is going to become normal. And unfortunately, there are a lot of things in the black community that are unacceptable, or at least should be unacceptable, yet they become normal, or quote-unquote normal. But as Tony Soprano would say, what are you gonna do? Well, that's my video. Peace out.